it was really terrifying because I didn't know how long it would take or if I would recover. I didn't know if I'd be able to use my arms again.
Jenny Wright's body is broken in many, many places.
Two broken upper arms. Both my humerus are broken. I have plates that go from my shoulders down to my elbows on both sides. My left wrist was also broken and it has plates and bolts as well. And my fingers, three breaks in this arm, as well as in my ankle. Some ribs, of course, and sternum gets smashed up from the steering wheel and wearing a seatbelt and the impact of airbags.
This is what's left of the vehicle she was driving on January 2nd. It's a photo she can't bear to see.
I have a very emotional reaction to it because what I think about is that my daughter was in there.
Her 27-year-old daughter Shelby and her 90-pound dog Charlie were in the vehicle with Wright as she was driving home to St. John's after the holidays.
I saw a white transport truck and I noticed that the white transport truck was fishtailing. And then within a split second that truck jackknifed and the trailer came around.
Then instinct took over, a mother's instinct.
I thought that was it. But I had this moment I wanted to put some distance between that and my daughter. And so I cranked the wheel and hit the gas to go right.
The driver's side took the brunt of the impact. Shelby's knee was shattered. Charlie the dog was unhurt. But Wright was trapped.
And I knew I was not in good shape. I knew I was. I was pressed against the steering wheel and I was having trouble breathing. And, you know, they were having trouble getting me out.
2 hours it took to free her, to pry apart the vehicle with the jaws of life.
Luckily, the body's an amazing thing, and I just kind of went into shock and so that I couldn't feel the pain.
What followed were 2 weeks in hospital, several surgeries, and total dependence on everyone for everything.
It is life-changing. I don't think I've ever been this dependent on others or this vulnerable.
An unnatural state for her. Wright is a fierce feminist, a champion of women's rights. She doesn't do vulnerable.
I couldn't sit up. I couldn't go to the bathroom on my own. I couldn't eat. I couldn't do anything. It's scary to suddenly be incapable.
She's not a fan of the cliche, lucky to be alive.
I think everybody I know has said to me, you're so lucky.
This does not feel lucky.
As my husband says, lucky is winning the lottery, not getting hit by a transport truck.
Lucky or not, she is grateful to be alive.
I'm eternally grateful every day that I didn't have any injuries to my spine or to my legs or to my head. I'm grateful for, you know, a series of events that happened that probably saved my life.
A life that's on hold for now, with at least a year's worth of healing ahead and a new appreciation for a future she almost didn't have.
I think in the end it'll make me, you know, stronger and more fierce.